the German government got involved in this stuff too. And the landfill account, you keep an eye on the landfill, you know, spontaneous fires from the walls, the concrete, which is part of it.
No. With what's happening here, I would be very concerned about other things happening.
Yeah.
But again, what I'm asking for is technically, what did you have on to produce this effect?
At this particular time, it went very big with the lab, instead of only 4,000 watts, 110 volts, it was close to 3,000 watts, 110 volts, and put into all the equipment. I had the 1 million volt Tesla power running.
Okay.
The 2 million volt electrostatic units I made running at that time, along with them. Half a million volt electrostatic units with battery back generators.
Okay.
I had a unit called, which helped a lot, called, they found a purpose, called the Wave 17 by 15. It's a radar, programmable radar system for counter intelligence and countermeasures, radar systems.
Yes.
I just put out next band radar, and well, maybe roughly 10 to, as I recall, 100 milliwatts.
Okay.
That was focused into the field. And I had also a pulsating magnetron, a mechanically pulsed magnetron.
Good Lord, you had a whole soup of things, electromagnetic and otherwise, going on in there.
Quite a bit. I had at least the equipment weight in that time period by the moving test, 22 tons of stuff.
Well, that 22 tons?
22 tons. I peaked up at that level, had so many different other
experiments
around too.
John, if I might ask, equipment of this magnitude would take some amount of financing to put together.
That it would. Now, if you're to buy these things off the shelf, you'd be running into many, many millions.
Right.
However, in Canada, there's many scrap yards, surplus yards, where a few of the stuff came to me. I go to one place called Convoy Electrical Machinery, and there I found almost exactly what this of the Colorado Springs Tesla transformer, Westinghouse 56 KVA.
Right.
And basically, they didn't want it, and they said they'd deliver it. They wanted to get rid of it. Over and over again, I set up a network. People told me, "Hey, well, we got a few transformer DC voltage, 20,000 volts."
So people watched what you were doing, and as they heard about it, they made donations.
They made donations of stuff. Basically, yeah, they gave stuff, and sometimes they had to purchase stuff. They're cheap. We had so much army equipment, so much other types of equipment. And the old wire, back 100 years ago, let's say, was available in scrap there. Nobody wanted it,
except you mind. Hold on, John, hold it right there. You've got to see this. It's to my website, rfl.com. Program tonight's guest will be on the end of videos. Seeing is believing. I'm Mark Bell. I've got to John Hutchinson. And John, it says here that your effect has been very well documented and seen many times by credentialed scientists and engineers. Now, if a credentialed scientist or engineer that would actually witness what I'm seeing on video tape, I'd be really curious what they'd have to say.